I think I always thought that it was going to take a certain amount of records or time before certain preconceived ideas of what I should sound like or what I should be or how I should act would diminish and people would start seeing me again for what I am, which is essentially a songwriter, singer. I've got the keys to the world, Jim. What you gonna do when we get there? I never really understood how powerful lyrics were until I wrote a few songs. I had no idea how music and melody and lyric can just slice through every wall, you know, whether it's race, you know, class, all these things. You know, in a few minutes, in a few lines, you can turn the world's head. Here we go again. In a busy couple of years. After Human Conditions, we did some dates in Europe and England. Once I'd finished doing a certain amount of gigs, I went back to the songs that I'd written at the very end of Human Conditions. Went into an old Valve studio in London. Most of the songs come from that session. So a lot of my time was spent being creative. The first song to be recorded on the album was the first single, Break the Night with Colour, and that was done on a harpsichord. I've got a nice harpsichord at home, very lucky now these days, very posh harpsichord. You can even see on the video I've got a very claw-like action which no other piano player's got because I was never taught how to play the piano. So I did my chopstick hook claw thing on Break the Night on the harpsichord and it sounded good. And when I went to the chorus and did the first ooh ooh. Sometimes it's just a ooh ooh, man. It doesn't have to be the times that are changing. Sometimes it's a yeah, yeah, yeah. Sometimes it's a sha-la-la, you know. So it's one of those moments I just thought, God, there's something there.
Is to create some sort of an idea, a feeling that being frozen in time.
You can be a prisoner in your own mind, you can be a prisoner in many different aspects, so I think that's where it links with the tune, really.
And it's also I Don't Want to Know Your Secrets. It mirrored the fact that I'm so sick of everybody giving me their lives, man. Their inside leg, you know. He's not my child, DNA test live on air, or whatever it may be. It's a reaction to that. It's the opposite to, like, Beatles, I Want to Know Your Secret. I don't want to know your secret. Let's break the night with color sound for us to move ahead. Music is Power, yeah, originated from a Curtis Mayfield sample. I just got the loop and put on acoustics, banjos, pianos, electric guitar, another lot of strings. Music is power. Just the term itself must have come in my head just through my own personal experiences of people telling me about how a different track would inspire them. This music is the mantra. Should be out in June, July, just, you know, should be out on the festivals. Music is power. Let it flow through your mind, you know, simple as that. These are wild, wild, wild things you live in, yeah. I just wanted to make a few tunes that were memorable purely because the melody lodged in your head before you even know what you're singing. And then that's where it becomes interesting. I've got people singing. What are they actually singing?
Sweet brother Malcolm, he's under house arrest. It's the talk of the town.
I wrote at the time two or three songs that were sort of character-based, and this one stuck out more than the others. Sweet cousin Mary. it's almost like your imagination letting itself go, looking out of a window at a bunch of flowers. It's like a daydream in a way that Eleanor Rigby tune is, where you give a character a little world around them. Now nothing remains. Now, I don't want to get too heavy about what I do. I want it to be inspiring, I want it to be up. Why Not Nothing? It was one of the earliest songs that came, the start of it came at the very end of the Human Condition session. Ever since Anyone Hears and Waiting for a Man by the Velvets, you know, you always want to write your two chord classic. And lyrically, I think it's the opposite of a sort of psychedelic lyric. It's so in your face. You know, the opening line, I ain't got time for your politics, you're masquerading Machiavellian tricks now. That could be for any number of people. It says it's a hard road on your own, you got to learn the way you do. And that's almost a reference to me being on my own as well as a solo thing, you know, you're finding my way through that. Why Not Nothing, it's one of those little statements that might stick for a while in people's heads. It's not a statement of sit on your couch and do nothing, it's a statement of why not nothing. And I'm not saying I'm going to change anything, but I want to be part of the people who just throw in little nuggets now and again that give a different angle on life. I do not know what's real, I'm blue screen. Let's say that I Am the Walrus threw up psychedelic lines at you that you could chew on. This is totally the opposite. This is throwing up bizarre little truths, bizarre little nuggets that you can chew on for a while, you know. Got a few references in there that people can make up their own minds who the God Squad are, they can make their minds up themselves, and you know, just enjoy it. It's a good rock and roll song. I'd hate to be a guy out there singing these tunes that just didn't mean anything to me. I mean, it'd be terrible. If you want to scratch the surface on it, there's got to be something underneath, and believe me, there is, and I think that's why I seem to have quite a loyal sort of fan base, because they're on the journey with me now, and they want to know what the next instalment is, really, in a bizarre way. I've always thought about the trip I'm going to take them on. Are you going to take Why Do Lovers? Are you going to stick that on at 2 a.m? Are you ready for it? Go for it. Stick Why Do Lovers on and see if that one works. Come now, baby. Stay in bed, don't think that it's lazy. Why Do Lovers is really, you know, spend so much of our lives with our peacock feathers out. Especially when you're falling in love. Isn't warm, stay sweet, honey. You do your level best to hide every last drop of your insecurity, all that stuff, you know. And at some point in any relationship, it's got to come out. Them tell us there isn't one. Yeah, you didn't play with my feelings. Like the I think My Cry to the Morning's a kind of sister song to Why Do Lovers in a way. You said it's time to do some bleeding. Time to cry the past away. There's a bit of danger in that song, there's a bit of creeping danger. It's amazing how many people meet each other these days through the computer, and they have no idea of the history of these characters. That's what it's about. It's about, do you really know what you're getting into? Yeah, Perspex Confession Box was going to be the album title, and whether I hold that one back or not, I don't know, but Keys to the World came through. It was one of the songs that was based around a loop more than a traditional Saturday piano or acoustic guitar. Keys to the World really is this character running through institutions, falling through the net.
Institutions, you ran through them, from the age of five.
I'm kind of playing someone who's got the keys, but I'm trying to explain to someone that it's a suicidal world out here anyway, you know. We're always trying to help people get better, but what are we actually trying to get them better for?
You die.
We may dream of the lottery win, but what is it actually anyway? It's already rotten. I know that sounds very negative, but hey, so what? In a way, sometimes the simplest songs are the hardest to write. That's the oldest tune. That's a tune I have had for years. And I've always tried to get it on a record.
I opened up my eyes, swear I saw the light.
When I was in the Valve studio with the players, we just did a searing version of it and I worked on that and built on it.
Tell me, does it feel good? Tell me, does it feel right? I'm singing, singing, I'm singing, singing, I'm singing, singing, simple songs.
On my last album, Nature is the Law, it's about how I get through it by understanding that it's all ultimately more about that at the end of the day, baby. Keeps turning. I just wrote that on the piano. I've got this scale going, and then there's the classic bar chords in the chorus. Everyone has to do a song with that chord structure, and at some point in their life, maybe that's what the record is about. Really, I've not got time now to just to be the dreamer, sit down there. You know, I just got to get on with it, reflect what I can, try and write some great songs, try and be a better dad, a better husband, and get on in life. You know what I mean?
But the tears will flow, and just like the blood on the street.
When you've given all you've got.
Words just get in the way. That was two different versions, so almost spliced together. One that I did in the Valve studio with the strings and the guitar solo, and another version I'd done earlier.
There's no one left to call, call me.
It's just someone who needs help, and he needs it now. He doesn't want any more bullshit.
When you feel so full.
Again, it might be a reference to the music, to the song. That, I mean, what I've found is I'm much better at communicating in songs than I am in real life, and I think a lot of people find that who write songs.
If you want it, oh love, I've got it. Words may just get away.
Great guitar solo, the best guitar solo I've ever had. I mean, I'm not a fan of guitar solos because obviously after Hendrix and a few characters like that, you can't really go anywhere. But there's a beautiful sensitivity to the solo in this that was done by Terry, who ran the studio. I'm kind of honoured to have those kind of guys on it. There's certain people that you meet and you play with and you think, yeah, let the guy fly because he's got something to offer here, you know. That's one of the beautiful things of recording, you know, when you let people go, where's it going to go? And it can also be a really frustrating part of recording, you know what I mean? The playing on Why Do Lovers is just great, you know, it's that kind of thing that I've waited for a long time to be able to do that.
If you want it, all of I've got it, words they just get away.
I wanted to leave people room to think, not be bombarded by 15 sermons on life, you know, I just wanted 10 little nuggets. I wanted it to be quite no flab on the record. It became very difficult at the end picking the 10, just because I had quite a few songs. Ultimately, the strong ones really did shine through. The journey continues, and I still feel the best is yet to come, you know.